We want to determine the domain and the range of f of x, which is graphed here as a set of points. We want to write the answers as ordered lists enclosed in curly brackets. The domain of a function is a set of all possible inputs, or x values, and the range is a set of all possible outputs, or function values, or y values. So let's begin by determining the ordered pair for each point of f of x. Let's work our way from left to right. Notice this first point here has an x-coordinate of -6 and a y-coordinate of +2. So this point would be -6, 2, which means f of -6 = 2, and therefore -6 is in the domain of f and 2 is in the range. Next we have the point -4, 5. Therefore, -4 is in the domain and 5 is in the range. Next we have the point -2, -2. So -2 is in the domain and -2 is also in the range. Then we have the point 1, 5. So 1 is in the domain and 5 is in the range. Next we have the point 3, 1. So 3 is in the domain and 1 is in the range. And finally we have the point 4, -3. So 4 is in the domain and -3 is in the range. Now let's go ahead and make our list. The domain, again, is a set of all possible x values. We do want to order these from least to greatest, so let's work our way from left to right. The domain will be -6, -4, -2, 1, 3, and 4. And the range, from least to greatest, we'll work our way from the bottom to the top. So the range will be -3, -2, 1, 2. Notice how we have 2 points with a y-coordinate of 5. We're only going to list 5 once in the range. So again, we have -3, -2, 1, 2, and 5. This is the domain, and this is the range of the given function f of x. I hope you found this helpful.